Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a faulty engine coolant temperature sensor. The engine coolant temperature sensor, also known as an ECT sensor for short, does exactly what the name suggests, and its main responsibility is monitoring the temperature of your engine's coolant. It's a very simple part that often doesn't fail or have problems on most modern vehicles. It tends to be a lifetime part, but when you do run into issues with the coolant temperature sensor, it can cause a host of symptoms and potentially drivability issues. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common symptoms with a faulty ECT sensor. Number one on the list, we have a check engine light and fault code stored in the ECU. So this is very simple and basic. Nearly any problem on a modern vehicle will probably immediately trigger the check engine light or some sort of warning light. And that is no different with issues with the engine's coolant temperature sensor. So being an electrical sensor, as soon as it does have any problems or false inaccurate readings, the car's computer or ECU should pick up on that almost immediately and trigger that check engine light and also store the associated fault codes in the car's computer. So you can pull those with an OBD2 scanner, which is usually the first best step in diagnosing and figuring out any problem with your vehicle. Some of the most common fault codes to be on the lookout for with a faulty ECT sensor include P0116, P0117, P0118, P0119, as well as P0128. The first four codes specifically indicate an issue with the temperature sensor, and the final fault code, P0128, can indicate temperature readings or discrepancies. So ultimately, any of those fault codes can point to an issue with your vehicle's engine coolant temperature sensor. Moving on to the second symptom, we have inaccurate temperature gauge readings. Now this makes sense since, again, the sensor monitors the temperature of your engine's coolant. So if the sensor is faulty and not working properly, it can cause inaccurate readings on your instrument cluster as that number is simply pulled over from what the car is reading via the coolant temperature sensor. So if you're seeing your temperature isn't changing at all, or maybe it's fluctuating and bouncing rapidly between hot and cold, or it looks like your engine is severely overheating or not heating up at all, these can all be signs that you have an inaccurate reading from that temperature gauge, which can point back to issues with the engine coolant temperature sensor. So very simple symptom. If you suspect you're having this issue, pay attention to that temperature gauge. Next, for common signs and symptoms of a faulty engine coolant temperature sensor, we have the vehicle overheating or overcooling. So overheating or overcooling are both possible outcomes if the engine doesn't know the actual temperature of the coolant circulating throughout the engine. Now, on most modern cars, it will be much more likely to run into situations where the engine is overcooling itself and potentially taking a very long time to get up to operating temperature, or potentially not even reaching operating temperature at all. And that is because if the ECU knows that it is not getting accurate information on the coolant temperature, then it should fail safe to essentially overcooling the engine, ensuring that that thermostat is wide open and essentially allowing maximum coolant flow through the radiator and maximum cooling capacity. However, on the other hand, you could also run into issues with the engine overheating, and that could be caused if the engine thinks it's way too cold and it's trying to allow itself to heat up. It might actually close the thermostat and basically remove most of the cooling capacity of the cooling system. So that could lead to overheating. But again, this is very uncommon, especially on modern cars. But overheating is a lot more serious. So if you are noticing any symptoms of overheating, then it's a good time to pull over immediately, have the vehicle towed, since that can be a lot more dangerous to the engine. If the engine is overcooling, overcooling really isn't going to cause any harm. It can be bad in the very long term over the course of years and years and tens of thousands of miles. Moving on to our fourth and final symptom, we have poor fuel economy. Most modern cars will run in both open and closed loop fueling, and a faulty reading from the coolant temperature sensor can cause the vehicle to actually stay in open loop fueling. Basically, what open loop fueling is what most cars start up on. Initially, they have very set parameters for fuel flow, airflow, etc. And so in that open loop fueling, it's a very predetermined number that the engine targets, and it's usually not based on all of the data from sensors and other information the ECU is reading. So basically in those situations, the engine tends to run a lot richer, and as it warms up, the engine will switch to closed loop fueling, meaning it's actually starting to read information from different sensors, like the coolant temperature sensor, to actually determine the proper air fuel mixtures. And in those situations, it will often be a lot leaner, which means better fuel economy. So ultimately, if your vehicle is stuck in that open loop fueling, then it can cause poor fuel economy. And alongside that, you might also notice some other drivability issues and symptoms like poor performance overall and potentially rough idle or stuttering, stumbling, hesitation, etc. Now, with all the symptoms out of the way, what does it look like to actually replace and fix your engine coolant temperature sensor? So fortunately, this is a very easy and inexpensive job. Most people who kind of know their way around an engine should be able to knock this out at home in your driveway or garage in probably no more than about 10 to 30 minutes. The coolant temperature sensor is often located on the cylinder head of the vehicle, and a lot of the times it will be right near your engine's thermostat. Most vehicles, this shouldn't really require moving any additional parts out of the way to access the coolant temperature sensor, which is why it's generally such a quick, easy repair. Looking at the cost of the coolant temperature sensor, they generally cost about $10 to $50. So very cheap part, easy to replace. Again, something that most should be able to do on their own in the driveway in less than 30 minutes. So a lot of the times, if you suspect that you do have an engine coolant temperature sensor issue, it can make sense to just go ahead and replace that part preventatively, replace it up front, even if you haven't done additional diagnostics and confirmed that as the issue. Just since it is such a cheap, simple part to replace, a lot of the times, again, it's worth it to just go ahead and knock that out. Even if that isn't the root cause of your problems, it still won't hurt to replace something that essentially makes it less likely to run into this issue further down the road. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.